7:30 a.m. Olivia Gomoshabe arrives at her preaching spot in Chireka, a busy Kampala suburb. She's dressed appropriately to address those who care to listen and comfortable enough to head to the office right after her session. The 27-year-old engineer is not alone on this mission. She's joined by an army of volunteers from her church.
He was patient with all the things he went through.
While growing up in Kampala, Gomoshabe interacted with street preachers, but she never imagined herself behind the microphone crisscrossing stages in the city.
I haven't been preaching since I was a child. I think to tell the truth, I never saw myself ever on a street. It's first time is can freak you out.
Her career dreams were not far from what she became professionally. Gomoshabe attained a bachelor's degree in industrial engineering and management from Chambogo University.
I think that change happens before you even go on the street. The street is just a product of a work that has already happened. You get it? Yeah, so you've had an experience of God. Look at it this way. You've had an experience of God, and then you just can't sit there. It's like you are cheating the world.
Because there was a gift.
It's an old practice, but one that is ever growing as more youth take religion to the streets. There's no data to show the specific number of street preachers, but the upward trend is worrying some pastors.
The qualifications for preaching on streets, I think this is a very, very sensitive issue. I think the qualification would be, if we are to do it, we need people who are so much patient, who are grown up in the world, who are really, really, and even the dressing code should really, really represent the gospel.
Public preaching should be focused on the people around. In other words, preach to those who are nearby and may be interested in the world, Pastor Musime argues.
People who are walking by have their own issues, and sometimes they are not into that. Sometimes you just preach one word and the person has left. So I think they should so much concentrate on those people around them. I think that would be the best perspective, but not these people who are just traveling and sometimes, because there are these people that annoy them, but if they concentrate on those people around them in the shops and who are nearby, I think that would help so much.
His point that gospel should go beyond words to inspiring and allowing the Holy Spirit to refine them doesn't deter this legion that preaches on the streets twice every week.
It's not really done by men with churches or ministries. You find the least expected people preaching. Just someone who has been touched with the love of God. And they may not be having any position in the church or anywhere, but they just want to serve God through letting people know about the message of Jesus Christ.
Now, usually before you go on the street, you feel like you need to know a lot of scriptures, that sort of thing. You, are you sure? Because people, you meet guys and they are quoting and they are like, now what am I going to tell people? So the first time, you're freaked out. You are really, really freaked out. But I think for me, I got early an experience of the love of God. Yeah, so it's something that is easy to talk about.
At the end of the session, Gomoshabe wears her engineer's hat and reports to work at a place that has incorporated her street preaching into their schedule.
The first thing is that we have a flex time policy here. The work time that is taken out is compensated, that's one. But it's also important that if street preaching is something that is important to her, it's important that she goes and does it and then finds time to come back to work. I don't see it affecting her work in any way.
The book of 1 Timothy chapter 3 defines a pastor. Qualifications include a person that has a good reputation in society. Street preaching can be a stepping stone to the podium. However, Gomoshabe has yet to consider elevating to that level. Razia Athman reporting for the news in Kampala.
We thank you because when we have people.